Hello and welcome to Enchantment of Eternity's ranking Star Trek's Helmsmen. This video is a part of a series of videos where I rank the various characters of a specific position of on Star Trek. So in this video, I am going to cover the helmsman, that is the pilot, the person who flies the ship, and I'm going to rank them from what I think is the least effective to the most effective. So how I rank these is I base them off their what I believe their personal skills to be as a helmsman. And that doesn't just include, like, who flies the ship the best, but also, like, who would be the best Starfleet bridge officer to have on my bridge? Who would I want advising me and going on away teams and stuff like that, as well as, of course, being the helmsman? Because, honestly, like, I think this position was a bit harder to judge because anyone can fly a ship. I mean, come on. But it's more of what do they bring to the bridge, and who would I want at my helm. So as always, it's not based on which character I personally prefer or which ones I don't like. Otherwise, this list would look very different. It's who I think is most skilled, and of course, it is still just my opinion, though. With the helmsman, I choose one character from each of the Star Trek shows. I don't know if there's any show that has more than one helmsman, but but regardless, I limit it to one character per show, in which I cover. In this case, I think I'm going to cover 6 Star Trek shows, the original series, Next Generation, Deep Space Nine, Voyager, Enterprise, and Discovery. So, let's go ahead and name the characters that I will be ranking. So, first from the original series, it's Lieutenant Sulu. And then from Next Generation is Wesley Crusher. From Deep Space Nine is Jadzia Dax, since she piloted the Defiant. Whenever they flew the Defiant out on ship, she was usually the pilot. Tom Paris from Voyager, Ensign Mayweather from Enterprise, and Lieutenant Detmer from Star Trek Discovery. So let me go ahead and I think all those are all pretty self-explanatory, except for Dax, but I already explained her because, you know, Deep Space Nine was mostly taking place on the station, so they didn't have a helmsman, so I had to go by when they went on the Defiant in later seasons, and Dax usually took the helm, even though she's like the science officer, but, you know, a science officer wouldn't have much to do on a warship, so they usually had her be the helmsman instead, which is fine. Like, alright. Anyway, let me go ahead and rank them from who I think is the least effective to the most effective, and I am going to start with, as the least effective, Lieutenant Detmer. As I said, anyone can fly a ship, and as a pilot, she was very competent. She managed to fly Discovery through some tricky situations, including a couple battle situations, no less when she flew the ship and when that AI, what was it called, Control, when it split up into all these tiny little ships and was attacking them. She did a good job, but she lost her nerve a bit easily. Now, I know I'm not making light of PTSD. I know it's a serious thing, and that should be taken seriously, but I think she lost her nerve rather easily as compared to some of the other people on this list who I think could have went through the same thing and not freaked out and started yelling shit at people. Personally, that is just my take on it. And other than that, she doesn't really stand out. That's the only time she ever stood out is when she lost her shit. Other than that, she was just, you know, a competent pilot who is just there. So, who just says, "Aye, sir," and and just pushes the buttons. So that's why she ended up at the bottom for me. Next to the bottom is Mayweather from Enterprise, kind of for similar reasons, although he didn't lose his ship, but he also didn't stand out. He didn't really do much in terms of being an effective bridge officer. As I said, he was a competent pilot who also managed to fly in some battle situations, particularly with the Zindi and also when during the Vulcan Andorian conflict. But, and he flew some shuttle pods on away missions, and he always managed to do a good job at doing that as well. But as a bridge officer, he didn't really stand out. He didn't really offer much. He didn't really have much to do. He was just kind of there and saying, "Hi, sir," punching the thing. And, you know, every once in a while, he'd bring up the fact that he was grew up on a freighter, but never really helped. So then we get into the next entry on my list, Wesley Crusher. Now, I think I may be being a bit unfair to him, because if I went off what they presented in the show, he technically probably should be my number one, because he saved the universe several times. But the problem is that when that happened, I find that as really contrived writing. So, I know I said I'm going to leave my personal like or dislike of certain characters out of it. Otherwise, my worst would be a totally different character if I was going by which characters I personally like. But that's not the case here with Wesley, because I can't say, oh, he's the best helmsman because of contrived writing when he constantly is, when he's a Mary Sue. I'm sorry, I'm just gonna flat out and say it. He was a Mary Sue, and I don't think that deserves being the best helmsman if the character is written as always being brilliant and knowing how to save the universe. That's bullshit, in my opinion. Now, as far as being a competent pilot, like, to be fair, he probably didn't stand out as much as a competent pilot as the way as Detmer or Mayweather. They actually, like, flew better and flew in more hazardous situations, where Wesley kind of, the Enterprise D was more like a, you know, cruise liner where he just set a direction and went there. He never had to really do any sort of tricky maneuvering, not even in the conflict with the Borg. But I had to put him higher than those other two because, I mean, he saved the universe several times. So, but I couldn't conscious putting him at number one, because that was very contrived writing when he did save the universe. And other than that, like, I don't think he was a very effective bridge officer. Let me put it this way. If I was running a ship, I would not want him on my bridge. I'm sorry. You'd just be whining, "Well, sir." And I'd be like, "Shut up, Wesley." Anyway, let me get to the next entry on my list. And that is Jadzia Dax, who was not only, like, she was not known, of course, for her piloting skills. That just happened to be another skill set that she had. She was, of course, known most for being a science officer, but she was, in fact, a very effective bridge crew. She is someone who I would want on my bridge, because she was always astute, and was also, I mean, you get to two for one. You get a science officer and a helmsman who'd be able to analyze scientific situations and fly a ship very well. And during battle, like, she flew during a lot of battle situations during the Dominion Wars. So she was probably the most accomplished, like, battle helmsman on this entire list, to be fair. So yeah, definitely had to put her that high. So, then we'll get into my number two, my second highest on my list, and that is Tom Paris. Now, I said before, if it was going by which character I personally liked, Tom Paris would be at the bottom. I don't like him. But, to be fair, he is shown as effectively the best pilot. He created his own shuttlecraft. And he was able to do a lot of high-speed maneuvering, because Voyager is a very maneuverable ship. And he takes full advantage of that, and we see that in a lot of situations, and also when he has the Delta Flyer, which I think is a stupid name. But he manages to do a lot of really tricky and complicated maneuvering with the Delta Flyer. So if I was going off of just pure piloting skills, then Tom Paris would probably have to be my number one. But as I said, I'm not. I'm going on who I would want on my bridge. And I don't know so much if I'd want Tom Paris. I mean, I would definitely want him there more than Wesley. That's for damn sure. But, I mean, he was also a competent crewman. And he was someone you want. But he constantly challenged the captain. And sometimes he outright defied orders and had to be demoted. And whatnot, so that's definitely a strike against him. And plus, I just don't like how he constantly boasts about, oh, I'm the best pilot there is, I'm such a great pilot. Hey, Tom, why don't you just show us and not tell all the time? Stop being such an egotist. So I had to hold that against him as well. Anyway, so my number one helmsman who I would want on my bridge is Hikaru Sulu. Aye, Captain. The Klingons. But sir, the Klingons. I gotta give it to Sulu. Even though he may not have the piloting skills of someone like Tom Paris, but he is more dependable. He is definitely like a great, reliable bridge officer. He's even taken command of the Enterprise several times and did a very good job doing it. He is very astute and very alert, and someone who is, you know, very good at landing parties, and he's always able to back up Kirk, not defy him in the way Tom Paris would, but back him up and and be an asset to him and point out things that maybe Kirk didn't notice and look at things in different perspectives. And he's always there to fly the ship when they need to get out of situations, like when they need to escape the Genesis device blowing up. Go, Sulu! Captain. Gotta give it to Sulu for the best helmsman of Star Trek. So anyway, that is it for my ranking the Star Trek helmsmen. I shall be back sometime soon and going to rank some more positions. But in the meantime, you can check out my channel as I cover many other videos on Star Trek, as well as covering other shows like The Expanse, Breaking Bad, The Outer Limits, and more. So be sure to subscribe so you can keep up with all that. And thanks a lot for watching.